Hi, today I will discuss about how to build truss and solve the reaction and bar force. So let's go. This is the main truss problem file. So I want to first show you the result. Run it and it says the results printed in file truss one results. So I go there, truss one results. So you see here, first I introduce the truss here. This is the truss problem. This has three bars, 1, 2, 3, and it has three nodes. Node number 1, node number 2, node number 3, and the length here 4 meter and here 6 meter, and there is a horizontal load 12 kilonewton, and this is roller support, so it has only vertical reaction, and it is pin support. It has horizontal and vertical reaction, and this has no reaction. So go there and so the number of node 3, number of element 3, and number of nodes per element 2, and degree of freedom 2, and this is, and node xy, this is the length. You can call its coordinate, and there is global force vector, and you can also find members action, element force action. That means in the bar number 2 it has compression force, and in the bar number 3 it has tension force, and in bar number 1 it has no force. That means zero force. And there also displacement here, like bar number 3 it has this displacement and x displacement and y displacement, and displacement solution vector in here. So this is the outcome, I mean result file. So how can you define this truss in the MATLAB? I will discuss this in the MATLAB. So I build more than 7 files, and this is copyright from Introduction of MATLABs from Abqus. And this is a book's name. If you want the book's name, you give me an email. So first I introduce some technical terms so that you can understand it. The truss has three element, 1, 2, 3, node number 1, 2, 3, and each bar, like this is number 1 bar, each bar has two nodes. Node number 1, node number 2. So I define here, you see here, number of nodes per element, that is N and E equals 2. And number of elements, you see here, the number of element is 3. And number of nodes, N and D, 3. And number of degree of freedoms here, 2. That means I take here vertical, horizontal, and here vertical, horizontal, vertical, horizontal. There is no moment, and you see here first, this is the step, how can I approach the problem, data preparation input. Okay, this is the step, and this I define this geometrics, number of node 2, number of node is 3, so this is geom is 3 rows 2 column, a matrix, 3 rows 2 column, and a restraint degree of freedom is assigned, that degree 0. I mean there is restraint degree of freedom, we assign here 0, and for the free degree of freedom we assign here digit 1. And the boundary condition, the NF is called nodal freedom matrix, and you see here number of node and number of degree of freedom. Number of node is 3 and number of degree of freedom 2. That means it's 3 by 2 matrix. and we defined there. This is the global matrix, and we find here AE divided by L and minus AE divided by L, and this comes from the calculation. So let's go here. First, I introduce the main file. This is the main file. So I first I clear the all data in my scripts, and then I go here. If ID means file ID, feed means file ID, and it will open Truss one results and WW. Okay, for this notation, how can you know this notation? Go there. I give a link in here. Okay. So you see here W. So W means open file or create new file, writing, discard existing contents if any. This is the syntax of the file, how to open file, something. So you will get here some an R open file, and this is the notation. So you will get from here, and then there is FC close. You also find a print something. So there are also some percentages I want to introduce it. It will there is percent F, that means a digit string specify the minimum number of digit to be printed. 6.2 means a digit string include a period specify the number of digit to be printed to the number of decimal point. So I give this result printed in the Truss printed, that means this result printing model data, there printing model data Truss result. So go there, and there I say that Truss one data, that means this F feed will open this Truss one data file. So where is Truss one data file? Truss one data file, this is that Truss one data file. I open it. And here I define number of nodes 3 according to my Truss. According to this Truss, I define the number of node, number of element, number of element, and number of degree of freedom, and number of degree of freedom per element. So number of degree of freedom per element means here, if this has two degree of freedom, one is vertical and one is horizontal. Similarly here, one is vertical and one is horizontal. So total number of degree of freedom will be 4. So it depends on the node and number of degree of freedom. So I multiply it number of nodes and number of degree of freedom each nodes. So it gives you this, and GOM I define first. I define these zeros. So let's run it. Yeah, so that means geometrics. I define this geometric. So this is first I call this is zero matrix. So in the next term I called it that XY coordinate of node 1 00. So go there. Here the coordinate of this node is 00, and this coordinate is x coordinate is 400 and y coordinate is 0, and this has x coordinate is 400 and y coordinate is 6000 millimeter. So I define in here, and so when you define this, the other matrix will be automatically 0. I mean this element I put this, there is 400 and there is 400, and there is connection element connectivity. So connect. So let's go. when you run this matrix, that means number of element is three. So this is 3 by 2 matrix, 3 by 2 matrix. So connectivity means like that. This one node connect with 2, and 2 node connect with 3, and 3 node connect with 1 again. So it depends on the number of element. So I define here 1 connect with 2, 2 connect with 3, and 3 connect with 1. And this is the first and second node. That means first and second node. So go there and prop. So what is prop? Prop means this is properties of the bars. So I again define this 0 0. I mean I made the prop matrix 0 0, and here you see that E and A element of 1. That means this is the E, the modulus of elasticity, and this is the area of the element 1. That means this is modular, this is for bar 1, and similarly for bar 2 and bar 3. And this is the prop function, and this is the boundary condition. So NF means nodal degree of freedom. So I write in here, you see, that means NND means here number of degree 3 by 2 matrix, 3 by 2 matrix, and all oral element are 1. So some of the, this is initialized of the nodal matrix 1, and this nodal freedom matrix I defined number 1 row and number 1 column, this element 0, this element 0, and 2 means this element 0, and back and the other number of members are 1 1 1. So this is the loops. That means I defines I 1 2 number of node. That means it will go 3 1 2 3. This loops rotate, and this is the zero load matrix. It will give here. Load matrix is 3 by 2, and when I define 3 column and all of the rows, 3 rows, all of the columns, so it means 0 0. So and it will give me 0 0, but I define this will give me 1200, because you see here this x, in x direction the load is 12 kilonewton, and y direction this is 0. So I define this so that it will not be 0. And this is the input file, truss input file. So you can change from here, like you can give 3 4 5 6 7, if you what is your, according to your bar number, and go okay. So I will discuss the later file in my second video. Please see my second video. Thank you for watching my tutorial.